Hey guys, if you've been keeping up with my channel at all, you know that Max and I had been traveling around Japan for a couple of weeks, and this is going to be my last Japan vlog, so if you haven't seen the previous ones, they are linked in the description box down below. But this vlog is going to be extra special because we actually decided to stay in a capsule hotel for our last night in Tokyo. We decided to stay in this capsule hotel called 9 Hours in Shinjuku. It's a really, really quiet hotel, so a lot of it I'm going to switch back and forth between voiceover and me talking in the video. So if you enjoy these kind of videos, make sure you let me know by giving this one a big thumbs up and subscribing to see more travel vlogs from me. So when you first arrive at the 9 Hours hotel, it tells you to go to the 8th floor for check-in. As soon as you get there, they give you a set of instructions, which are also plastered all over the walls, so you never really run the risk of being confused while you stay here. Once you are checked in, you receive your locker number, which is the same as your pod number, and you can head to your floor, which is separated by men and women. So once you check in, you get a locker pod situation. Here I am. They give you a little key card. Not bad. Once we got our lockers open, it was pretty apparent that our full-size suitcases were not going to fit in them, so we had to leave them at the front desk.
So unfortunately, since I've been here for 2 weeks because of Ultra, I had a full-size suitcase and it didn't fit. But it's okay, I just took out like my toiletries and my outfit for tomorrow.
So this locker comes with two hangers and a toiletry bag, which I will go through later when I shower, and just enough space to fit a small suitcase or my little backpack. After putting my stuff away in the locker, I walked around the women's floor and found where the toilets are, which doesn't sound that exciting, but they open up as soon as you walk in front of them, and I really appreciated that. So after exploring the women's locker room, Ivana and I headed back up to the 8th floor to meet up with the boys.
So we are back in the common area, which is the only floor that men and women are allowed to be together. Up here is a really nice view of the city. And they have this huge eating area and some desks over there if you want to get some work done.
Wouldn't be a trip to Tokyo if there wasn't a typhoon about to hit you, right? All right, we've made it to Shibuya Crossing. We're gonna head to Starbucks so we can get a bird's eye view. Quick stop in Shibuya for some sushi. As you guys know, Japan was kind of the whole start of the face filters with these photo booths, so Ivana found us basically a photo booth mecca.
Here they are, slightly terrifying. The rest of the day, we decided to do some light shopping in Harajuku and then end the night in Shinjuku because it was pretty close to our hotel and we just wanted to grab a few drinks.
And we're calling it a night, checking into the hotel. Let's see how it goes.
Sick.
Me and Ivana are back at our lockers and they come with pajamas and a towel, so we are going to go to the locker room floor and take a shower before we go to sleep.
So first things first, before we head to the showers, is to find our slippers that they provided. And man, do I feel stylish. The floor with the showers on it is actually huge, and I feel like even if this place was at full capacity, everyone would still be able to have their own shower, which is pretty awesome. I'm not gonna take you in the shower with me, but I can say that there are no complaints and the water pressure was amazing. Now check out these pajamas they provided. I can honestly say that what it lacks in sex appeal, it makes up for in comfort. Now you guys know I'm about to do my 10-step Korean skincare routine before I go to bed, and they actually provide a little travel toothbrush, which I wasn't expecting.
And now it's time to check out our pods.
Now you see, when the curtains are down, that means somebody is actually sleeping in there. Once we checked into our pod, Ivana and I realized that we were actually the first pods right by the door. And I recommend, if you decide to stay in one of these capsule hotels, you ask to not sleep here, because anytime the door opens and closes, it would literally give me a panic attack. Also, I thought that the door that separates you from the hallway would be, I don't know, like a hard plastic, but really this cover is only cloth, so it kind of scared me. The pillow was really nice, and they had this light dimmer right above your head, along with one charging port, and then this weird like divot that kind of looks like it's made for soap and is not big enough to hold anything, so I'm not really sure what you would put there. Another thing I didn't expect is it was extremely toasty in that pod. I was hoping that they would have some sort of temperature control, but I did not find any. Okay, and it is off to sleep. Overall, I would say I slept okay at the hotel. I think if you stayed there a few nights, you would obviously become accustomed to sleeping in a more public area, but I found that I couldn't really hit a deep sleep because I was so worried about someone opening my curtain for literally no reason. Once you pack up your things, you just return your slippers and you're off on your merry way. All right, and that was my experience staying at a capsule hotel in Japan. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you let me know by giving it a big thumbs up, and comment down below if you would ever stay in a capsule hotel. It is definitely a one-of-a-kind experience, and I recommend, if you have the opportunity to stay in one, you should stay in one, okay? Get away from those creature comforts and privacy. If you like this space, make sure you hit subscribe so you can see me next Thursday.